What was that? Did you hear that? Actually, I think Schultz is going to go to the Chargers to go hang with Kellen Moore. You watch. Bobby Wagner. If we could get Bobby Wagner in here, here's what's crazy about Bobby Wagner. You know, the deal that they had for Bobby Wagner for the Rams was not a bad deal. Bobby Wagner, last year's cap number was $2.5 million. This year was $12.5 million, $15 million for 2 years. $15 million for 2 years for Bobby Wagner. Bobby Wagner had, the year before, when people said, when the Seattle Seahawks let him go, oh, he's washed. He's done. He had 170 tackles that year. Brady B, Cowboys restructure. Uh-oh. Is that break? Is that da-da-dunt, da-da-dunt?
Da-da-dunt, da-da-dunt.
Damn, Gina.
It's been one of those days, dog, Brady. It's been literally one of those days that every time I turn around, I had to do another video. Because it was always breaking news. So let's see. Did you get the details on Michael Gallup's restructure? Now, I know that they could get about $8 million. So that would probably get us up to about $23 million. So here's the thing. $23 million. $23 million, you can start thinking about doing a lot more. If they do get some money from Zeke, let's say they get the $11 million from Zeke. Or $5 million from Zeke if they just cut him. Now we're talking about $30 to $35 million. Okay? So if you let Leighton Van Der Esch go and you upgrade to Bobby Wagner, who last year, let's be clear here. Bobby Wagner had 140 tackles last year, 6 sacks, 2 interceptions. Ended up being the team's defensive MVP. Defense's MVP. Okay, Bobby Wagner on this defense, and you basically look at this for 2 years, okay? 2 years. Now, here's the problem. I can't believe the word is out because the Seattle Seahawks realize their transgressions and say, Bobby, come on home, Bobby. We were wrong. We did you wrong. We should have let you go, bro. Bobby Wagner. Come back, Bobby. Come back. They're trying to get him. We hear that the Ravens are trying to get him. But, maybe, just maybe, we have the ace in the hole. We have the ace in the hole in Dan Quinn. And Bobby Wagner, at this point, you know, in his 30s, when you get to be older and you've made a whole bunch of money and stuff, right now you start looking and saying, I want to get a chance to get another ring to solidify my legacy. You know what I'm saying? You know, because money, you know, you get older. Okay, money's a wonderful thing. I've never had a whole lot of money, okay? I've never had a whole lot of money, so I don't know. I'm assuming money's a wonderful thing, but, you know, that ring and having two of them, that's a lifetime. And so you may start looking at this and saying, well, if the Cowboys get me and they've got this money, if the Cowboys go to sell it and say, hey, look, and this is what I would be, this would be my philosophy. Because, you know, when Jerry Jones gets you into his office, because this is the thing that agents hate. Jerry Jones is a salesman. Jerry Jones has screwed more agents because he got the player into his office and got them to believe in the Jerry Jonesism. I can see Jerry now. Hey, Bobby Wagner, how you doing? You know, we got your man Dan Quinn here, and, you know, he's trying to rebuild that Legion of Boom defense, and we want to make you the focal point, my man. You know, we want you to be able to get that ring again, Bobby, and here's what we're going to do. We're not only going for you, Bobby. we're going to go ahead. We're going to try and make a move for a Stephon Diggs here. You know, we're going to go ahead. We're going to get ourselves another offensive lineman. We're going to go ahead. You know what we're going to do? We're going to do something that we never do here. We're going to get ourselves a big fat guy. I'm talking about like a fire hydrant. You ever back into a fire hydrant with your pickup truck and, you know, it just bends the crap out your tailgate? You know, that's what we're going to get for that defensive line. So that way, it keep them big old offensive linemen away from you, Bobby, so you can just fill the gap and just boom, just like the water boy, just take the man out. That's what we gonna do for you, cause you gonna be the center point, cause we going to Vegas. What happens in Vegas ain't gonna stay in Vegas now, Bobby. Yeah, we gonna take everything from Vegas and we gonna spread it around. What you think about that, Bobby? Yeah, can you come hook a brother up? And then he's gonna get Zeke, and hey Zeke, you know, Zeke Elliott, you know, I've made some mistakes, boy. I've been taking a whole lot of risk in my life, and not all the time does it work out, but here's what I want to do. Because, see, I messed up with Tony Romo and Dez Bryant and Jason Witten and those guys. Those guys should have left here with the ring. But, Zeke, here's what I want to do. I'm trying to get myself a team here that we can go through and we can continue to stomp the Eagles, and we can show the Eagles that when you get to that game, boy, you don't lose that thing. So what I need, Zeke, is I need you in there protecting Dak Prescott, you know, sacrificing some more of that body of yours and taking care of those short yardages. But see, I'm kind of short on some cash right here, because I need some, you know, I got to take some of the cash from here, and I got to sprinkle some over here, and I got to sprinkle some over here. So what do you say, Zeke? Zeke, will you come on back over here and help hook a brother up? Can you hook a brother up and come on back, because we're going for the glory this year, because you know I'm trying to write these checks, huh? Yeah, I know I said I can write those big checks, but I can only write $226 million of it on the salary cap. Okay, Zeke. All right. And Diggs, come on over here. Trayvon, you know, I want to pay you, son. But here's the thing, Trayvon, I need you to understand, we're going to try and get the family back together. I know you guys are kind of fighting a little bit here because you talk about who's faster than the other one. You know, your brother Stephon says he's faster than you, but I don't think I believe it there. But here's what we're going to do, Trayvon. You take care of me, I'm going to take care of you. You go ahead and get yourself a team friendly deal here, son. You know, I'm going to do everything in my power to go ahead and try and get your brother, because you know it's going to take at least a number one, son. So if we take a number one and trade it, you know, maybe we take a number one of those fives. We got three fives. So, we'll say a one and a five, that equals six. And maybe that's what it'll do. Maybe we can bring your brother here. But the problem is, we'll bring your brother here, it's going to cost a bunch of money. And then we don't have that pick. And we need that pick to get other people. So what we also can do, though, we can get other people, son, if we go ahead and we get some of that money, because guess what we might be able to do? Hey, maybe if we get a little bit of money from you, Diggs, you get that team-friendly deal right here. You know what we'll try to do? We'll go ahead. We'll try to get ourselves Jalen Ramsey. We'll put him on one side. We'll put you on the other. And then we'll put Bobby Wagner in the middle. Oh, my God. Can you picture this? You got Dak Prescott there throwing to Stephon, throwing to CD, and then we, oh boy, you got Zeke Elliott protected. We got Tony Pollard out there. Man, this thing would be just a beautiful thing now. But see here, I got the dream now, but I need your help. All you guys, I need your help for us to make this a reality. Let's see if we can get the band here together, and let's just go for it all. Can you picture that? That's all you need to do. That's what you need to do. Okay? Maybe it's not Diggs. Maybe Diggs is too far out there. You can get a Hopkins. You could go get an Adam Thielen, right? It's possible. You go through and you work that shit. If you do that, if you put a Bobby Wagner in the middle there, You go out and get a big fat guy, and I'm not talking about. No, I'm talking about, you know, where the pants where you literally. I'm gonna tell you about a guy. There used to be Eric Dorsey, who played for the New York Giants. He was a shot putter. Eric Dorsey was huge. He didn't play as well in the pros as he was, but this guy was huge. He went to McLean High School. We played football against him. He was a senior. I was a junior. I threw shot putters against him. But literally, you know, I'm looking up at Eric Dorsey. He had a brother that we called him the World. His brother was a big, I mean, big guy. He was so big that they literally took like three jerseys and sewed them together to make his jersey. And that's what I'm talking about for the defensive line. I'm talking about a guy that they got to take two pairs of game pants and put them together because his legs are literally that big. Just like you got Tyron Smith that's got to use a knee brace for his arm. I